बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, वेलकम टू द कैंटर पब्लिशर्स वीडियो लेसन्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू मस्ट हैव विद यू क्लास सिक्स इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर लेसन फ्रॉम यूनिट 5, द रैम्बो। SLOs ऑफ दिस लेसन आर क्लासीफाई एडजेक्टिव्स ऑफ क्वान्टिटी, क्वालिटी, साइज, शेप एंड कलर एंड ओरिजिन। रिकोगनाइज एंड यूज एब्सोल्यूट एडजेक्टिव्स। Page number 56 of your textbook, we are going to discuss the adjectives and adjectives of qualities. I know you are familiar with the adjectives. Adjective is that part of speech which describes noun and tell you more about the noun. Its origin, color, size, smell, everything. It can be bad or good both. Now look here. The adjectives that describe the quality of a noun are called adjectives of quality. For example, Karachi is a big city. Here the big is a quality of a city that it telling you that the Karachi, which is noun here, is big. The second example, Amjit was a great soldier. Here the Amjit is a noun and the great is an adjective of quality and telling you that Amjit was a great soldier. Let me give you one more example. I have a blue scarf. Here the blue is adjective of quality. It telling you that scarf, which is noun, is blue. It is its quality. So let's do the exercise here. Choose the appropriate adjectives of quality in the following sentences. The first one is, the girl has a voice. The girl has a red voice, the sweet voice, the fresh voice, or big voice. Which is appropriate? Can't be red, can't be fresh, can't be big. Yes, it is the sweet voice. We could have two options here, sweet and bad. Bad voice or sweet voice. Or good voice, but we don't have those options. We have only this one appropriate for it. So the sweet one is correct here. The second one is, Ali is a batsman. Fine, small, ripe or cruel. Ripe ka to matlab hota hai ki zyada paka hua. Ye kisi fruit ya vegetable ke liye use hoga. Cruel, zalim, no. The small. We could have the option of bad and fine batsman. So we have fine here. So fine is the right option here. It is the quality of that noun here, Ali, that he is a fine batsman. The third one, I like roses. Foolish roses, no. Roses can't be foolish. Naughty, no. Ugly, no. Yes, red roses. As I have given you example of color here, the quality of color. So the fourth one, you may eat mangoes. Bright mango, no. Pink, no. Ripe, bad. So which one is correct, ripe or bad? No, mangoes can't be bad. Yes, if its quality, it can be ripe or raw. So we don't have the option of raw. Raw means kacche aam. Aur ripe ka kya maine bataya tha? Pakka hua. Jo cheez pakki hui ho, sabzi ya fruit ke liye hum use karte hain ripe. तो यहां पर क्या होगा, राइप। यू मे ईट राइप मैंगोस। क्वालिटी है ये मैंगोस की। द फिफ्थ वन, मंकीज हैव व्हाट? लॉन्ग टेल, बिटर टेल्स, राइप टेल्स और अनकाइंड टेल्स। बिटर का मतलब होता है जायके में जो कड़वा होता है, या कोई बात कोई कड़वी कर दे, बुरी बात कर दे, तो इसे उसे भी बिटर कहेंगे। तो यहां पर ये inappropriate है, ripe भी बिल्कुल inappropriate और unkind भी। So the long is the correct option here. The sixth one, she sounded very on the phone. She sounded very major, no. Ugly, no. Angry or yellow, no. It can't be yellow. Yes, the angry is appropriate adjective for this. She sounded very angry on the phone. वो बहुत गुस्से में बात कर रही थी फोन पे। So this is the quality here. I told you earlier that quality can be both good and the bad. The seventh one here, there seems to be some interference on the line. Could you speak? Interference, koi interfere kar raha hai call mein. Call ab sahi nahi ja rahi, awaaz sahi nahi ja rahi. Toh yahan par kaun sa hum option choose karenge? Beautiful, bad, good or louder? The person is here requesting, could you speak one? Beautiful, bad, good or louder? Yes, he's asking him to speak louder because there is some interference on the line. Interference हो रही है कॉल में, तो वो उसको कह रहा है कि थोड़ा सा लाउडर बोलो. सो लाउडर इज द क्वालिटी हेयर. आई वॉन्ट यू टू चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस सेंटेंसेस टू बाय योर सेल्फ, 8, 9, and 10th. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द एडजेक्टिव्स ऑफ क्वांटिटी. क्वांटिटी हम नंबर में ले लेंगे, इसमें सम, मैनी, सेवरल, फ्यू, सब कुछ आ जाएगा. नंबर्स भी आ सकते हैं इसमें. क्वांटिटी है किसी चीज़ की, हम नाउन की क्वांटिटी बताएंगे हम. द एडजेक्टिव विच टेल द नंबर और अमाउंट ऑफ अ नाउन आर कॉल्ड एडजेक्टिव्स ऑफ क्वांटिटी. एडजेक्टिव्स ऑफ क्वांटिटी आंसर द क्वेश्चन लाइक हाउ मैनी और हाउ मच. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फोर बॉयज रैन डाउन द स्ट्रीट. हियर द बॉयज आर नाउन एंड द फोर इज क्वांटिटी. सो द क्वांटिटी ऑफ नाउन हेयर. स्टेप बैक 3 paces. द 3 इज क्वांटिटी हेयर. सो लेट्स डू द एक्सरसाइज हेयर. Choose the adjectives of quantity in the following sentences. The first one here, I have told you times already. Sweet times, no, it's quality. Fresh is also quality. Little, no, I have told you little times already. This is grammatically inappropriate. बोलने में भी ठीक नहीं लग रहा. So, I have told you many times is the right option here already. The second one, I speak words. Bright words, no, it's quality. Pink are also quality. Bad is also quality. Yes, few is a quantity. I speak few words. The third one, he is years of age. Long years of age, no, this is inappropriate. 90, ripe, no, unkind, no. Yes, the 90 here is a quantity. So, the 90 is the right option here. The fourth one, did you get marks? Major marks, ugly marks, mad marks, many marks. Yes, many is the right option here because these three are quality here. Only the many is quantity here. The fifth one, he made mistakes. Lovely mistakes, no, this is the quality. Good mistakes can't be lovely here. 10, no, the mistakes are not specified here. Is generally spoken. He spoke about the mistake generally. So, we cannot specify the mistakes that you have done 2 mistakes, 3 mistakes. Like this is not about the test or anything else. So, this is the generally talking. So, several will be the correct option here. I want you to choose the right option for these remaining sentences too. Now, let's move to the page number 58 and discuss absolute adjectives. What are the absolute adjectives? These are the tricky one, so you have to clear your concept too. Absolute adjectives do not have comparative and superlative forms. If something is complete, then this is an absolute adjective. For example, he's dead. Here the dead cannot be used in comparative and superlative sentence, like he's deader than me or he's deadest. There is no point of it. This is grammatically incorrect. You can't say this. If someone is dead and then dead, it can't be go to the comparative and superlative degree. You are either dead or not. You cannot be deader or more dead than someone. How can is this possible that you are deader and deadest? Dead is therefore an example of absolute adjective here. Let's do the exercise so you will learn about it more. Choose whether the following adjectives are absolute adjectives or not. So, look at the first one. The perfect is perfect. You cannot say that perfectest or perfecter. It has no superlative or comparative degree here. So, the second one is large. Is not an absolute adjective or an absolute adjective? Yes, this is the not an absolute adjective because it has comparative and superlative degree. Comparative degree is larger and the superlative degree is largest. The third one, complete. Not an absolute adjective or an absolute adjective. Yes, complete is an absolute adjective because it has no comparative and superlative degree. So, it is an absolute adjective. The fourth one here, extreme. Which one is this? Absolute or not an absolute? Yes, extreme is an absolute. Have you ever heard the extremer or extremest? So extreme here is an absolute adjective because it don't have comparative and superlative degree. So the fifth one is red. Red is what? Not an absolute or an absolute adjective? Yes, it is not an absolute adjective because it has the comparative and superlative degree. The redder, reddest. But if you go to the comparative and superlative degree of red, it can be more red and most red. These both are correct. You can use both. Both are correct. I want you to do these remaining by yourself. The 6th, 7th and 8th one. Square is, essential is and cold is. What? Not an absolute adjective or an absolute adjective? This is your homework from summer pack, page number 32. This is also your homework from summer pack, page number 33. And we also have an activity here. You have to what? Understand the difference between adjective quality and adjective of quantity. Recollect the image of your school and describe it using adjective quality and adjective quantity. This is very easy. The concept of both these two are very easy. You can do it. This is also your homework from summer pack, page number 34. And this is your homework from textbook, page number 53. This is your poem we are going to read in our next lesson about the Rambo. So you have to give it a read and identify all the three types of adjective we just discussed now, the adjective of quality, quantity and absolute adjective. I want you to spot out all the three types of adjectives in this poem here. I hope you have enjoyed my lesson. Thank you.